Thank you. It's getting late.
There's a poem that says, "Bright are the silver moon and the morning sun, yet life's blessed rest with the star-sown sky." There's a poem that says, "Right." Thank you. Since when did Fixstroll Garden become so...
Thank you. So that's all. No match for me. Thank you. that all? That's it.
The better.
In order to catch Heliobi on the run, the Ten Lords Commission has devised a few.
There's always this peculiar smell coming from there.
Started with today's operations.
The Ten Lords Commission Special Operations Team for the Heliobuzz Containment Breach Incident, aka the Ghost Hunting Squad, is ready for action! Yeah!
Yeah.
Huh?
Yo, why the exhaustion?
You look like the officers over at the Realm Keeping Commission.
I'm sleepy. Oh, little Gwei, what kind of magical elixir did you take to make you so energetic?
Every time I see our follower count increase, I get so excited I can't even sleep! It works better than any kind of tea or coffee.
Wow, aren't you lucky? As soon as I closed my eyes, I dreamt of endless running and circling and chasing after Lady Bailu. It was even more exhausting than doing it in real life.
Xuxiang, you slept for an entire day.
Catching ghosts is a night job. It only makes sense to sleep during the day. Yeah, I have an idea. How about we all just pretend that I've been possessed by a sleep ghost, let me sleep for another 10 hours, and then call it a day's work?
A certain celestial jade-playing divination commission employee, perhaps?
Divination Commission? Celestial Jade? Shouldn't they be doing divinations?
Thank you.
It's this girl. Here, look at this post.
Hi, take my job seriously. I'd never post something like late as usual on a public forum.
Miss Sushong, I think you missed the interesting part. The description in this comment is really suspicious. It definitely sounds like Heliobi activity to me. And if Heliobi have managed to infiltrate the Divination Commission, that spells big trouble for the Lafu.
You're right. Maybe we should contact Miss Qingchue and warn her not to go to work today.
That's a good idea. We should send out a message, or people's curiosity will get the better of them.
Notification sent. I guess now we should go to the Divination Commission and see what's going on.
But let's talk to Cirrus again first.
And Luxie in the Matrix. And I heard the cries of other Heliobi longing to break free. That would seem the Ten Lords Commission has everything under control. What is it you want from me?
One victory equals one question. Don't forget the agreement you made with the General.
Don't be so sure of victory before the battle begins, young one. Without Tail to protect you, isn't subduing a Heliobus a bit overwhelming for you? You know, if you can accept me with an open heart, I can take his place and help you.
Really?
Of course.
That's what I wanted to hear. The fact that you're trying so hard to persuade me means that you're not sure of victory either. If you were, you'd have devoured us without hesitation. Am I right, Cirrus?
Then have it your way. I'll destroy Qing Yuan's pawns here and now!
Thank you.
you're afraid of me.
Not a scratch.
I'll free you from your chains.
Disappear among the sea of butterflies. Illusions of the past. All in your misery.
The strength.
Has been infiltrated by Heliobus, but we don't know which one.
Entering the Xianzhou's window to the future, it must be none other than Kiraloom. They always relished, hounding your prophets and seers with questions of destiny. Watching them flounder between the random and the preordained. That pile of protein in your human skull is computationally inefficient. Your conjectures on destiny are little more than analogies and illusions. But we, the Shapeless, are different. When we come together to harmonize and observe, destiny is clear and vivid as firelight cast into darkness. Ugh, in warfare, nothing is more important than being able to predict your opponent's movements. Among the fragments of Ignimar, Kiraloom was in charge of knowing the past and predicting the future. It is said that during that fateful battle, Kiraloom had a premonition of failure, but Ignimar ignored their warnings.
It looks like we have a clear target this time. Let's get going.
I may not have the same predictive power as Kiraloom, little fox girl. One thing I do know is that sooner or later you will beg for my help.
Huh.
Time will tell.
Thank you. Thank you.
lonely. Nothing to do. Shall I wake you up? If you have something to say, then say it. If you open your heart to me, I can take you to witness your destiny. Forget it. I don't like tasting the same dish twice. Same goes for possessions. If it's destiny you wish to discuss, I might as well tell you that I never think on it. Or anything of the sort. Everything in this world will come to an end. It could be a trillion years from now, or tomorrow afternoon. It could be as a result of Nanook's pawns, or a sigh from the Nihility, or something else entirely. Eventually, this universe will be over, and all the species, long and short life together, all of them will end up in the same place. It's inevitable. But does the knowledge of this fact change anything? What does it have to do with you? If you knew the Lafu were to perish tomorrow, would you skip dinner tonight? The flame of the Heliobi will be extinguished in the hot silence of the universe. But that won't stop me from burning today. Destiny. Why should a fish worry about where the river flows? Lonely? Nothing to do. Shall I wake you up? If you have something to say, then say it. If you open your heart to me, I can take you to witness your destiny. You're the one who brought it up. If it's destiny you wish to discuss, I might as well tell you that I never think on it. Or anything of the sort.
You're here. Is that a Ten Lords Commission, Judge? Something's amiss in the Divination Commission. Everyone is mumbling to themselves. Is this some workforce overhaul? Did I set a bad example?
I'm afraid not, Miss Tingtre. Something unexpected happened. I'm just not sure how to explain it.
Well, anyway, there's a dangerous situation at the Divination Commission at the moment. So just don't go in there.
Good idea. With working conditions like these, I wouldn't be able to concentrate anyway. I heard from Alway that the Artisanship Commission is also experiencing strange phenomena. Several of the apprentices have started babbling nonsensically. It's kind of scary. Of course, it could just be a side effect of being denied graduation.
In that case, Miss Tingtre, could you stand guard here for us while we investigate?
It doesn't seem like a good idea to just stand here under such dangerous circumstances, does it?
I mean, you could leave, but... Wait, are you thinking of coming with us? Didn't you see how bad the situation was?
Yeah, I've seen it all right. But if I leave now, won't that count as an authorized absence? I can get away with slacking off, but the Master Diviner won't tolerate complete abandonment of my post. Besides, you guys need someone familiar with the Divination Commission to show you the way, right? Then let's go. What's going on?
to me, okay? I'm a little scared.
What are they looking at?
Is everyone okay?
There's only one way.
Divination is meaningless.
How did the Matrix of Prescience become like this? Look, Diviner Fu is standing at the center of the Matrix of Prescience. What is she doing?
Judging by her chanting, I think she's performing navigation calculations. Or divining. But something's not right. The Matrix of Prescience isn't moving at all. A Heliobus! Is that the danger you were talking about? I read about them in a book. Starfire essence that can transform itself. Enjoys manipulating the dreams and desires of mortals. You mean the Master Diviner is being controlled by something like that? How can we snap her out of it?
We could try ringing the harmonic chime. If we're close enough, we should be able to enter the Heliobus's illusion.
Silence! Idle chatter is not permitted in the Divination Commission.
Perhaps we should call you Caraloom.
It doesn't matter what you call me. I am the master of the Divination Commission. The current divination has reached a delicate stage, and no one is permitted to disturb it. Not even a judge of the Ten Lords Commission or a guest from the Astral Express. Chinchue! I have grown weary of your insubordination. Are you the one who brought these outsiders into the commission? Have you turned a deaf ear to all the rules I've laid down? Chinchue, you are hereby expelled from the commission.
That's... Darn! Now we're down one person.
A great idea! My days here really have been unproductive. Loafing around outside and playing Celestial Jade. All while taking a Divination Commission salary. It's... how to put it? Exactly. I do complete all my assigned work on time. I would call it... wasting my life away. Thank you, Master Diviner, for giving me the push I needed. Since you feel that my skills could be put to better use elsewhere, it's time for me to think about making some changes. But before I leave, I have to help these guests take care of some trouble here at the Commission. If I don't, people will think I was fired because of cowardice in the face of danger. What next? What do we do now? Giving a dramatic speech to my boss was cool and everything, but it's not gonna help her break free from the Heliobus clouding her mind.
I'm not sure what to do. The Heliobus isn't trying to trap us inside the illusion, and it doesn't look interested in attacking us either.
Clouding my mind? I've never been of clearer mind than I am right now. From now on, I will dedicate myself to defining the predetermined futures of the CMJO Alliance, and will make these futures known to the world so that all can live in clarity. I know what you want to say. Spare me the lecture on human wisdom prevailing over nature and those ridiculous notions of free will. These are but crude illusions created by the brain. From the beginning, there was only one path. You are nothing more than a pawn at the mercy of the Stellaron Hunters. What day you boarded the Express, who your enemies are, where you go. These choices that you think you make freely of your own accord are mere tributaries that will eventually converge on the path of destiny. Your journey to the CMJO, the defeat of Phantilia, all these were written into a script long ago by that slave to destiny, hidden in the shadows. Even in this very moment, your options are few. Ready your bat and charge at me. Argue with me loudly and futilely, or fall into silence.
Don't let her words get to you. There are always other options.
Come back to me when you've thought it through. Such trivial choices cannot change the inevitable. If you are still not convinced, I can demonstrate to you the true nature of destiny in a way that your human brain can comprehend. Then follow me.
What is this?
This place is what the Divination Commission calls the Pathfinder. It's a sandbox game that diviners use to simulate future paths and exercise our minds. Why did the Master Diviner bring us here?
That's right. Now listen. If you place an Ingenium in this little maze and give it a command, it will find its way to the exit precisely as it was commanded to do so. Are humans not the same as they navigate the path of destiny set before them? But you're probably thinking, humans are not machines. There is more than one path in the universe. And yet, machines we are. Complex, sophisticated, but machines. We are just like the Ingenium in this maze. We have no options to speak of. We can only navigate one path, the one that takes us to our destination. Let's begin. Lead the Ingenium to the exit. Show me how many choices destiny gives you.
It feels like we're dancing to the Heliobus's tune.
Let's begin. Lead the Ingenium to the exit. Show me how many choices destiny gives you. Well done. Your choices are as the Omniscia foresaw them. You should know that there was only one answer to this puzzle from the beginning, just as destiny has only one path.
Yes, for a puzzle that was designed from the start, choosing any other path would be a pointless mistake. But the universe isn't someone's game, and no one is designing puzzles for us to solve. The universe doesn't have a single answer. We can do anything we want while we're in it. Even if it's the same work every day, I can hide in the library and read a book, or find someone to play Celestial Jade with. And that's freedom.
I never thought slacking off could convince me of anything. A sign of a true scholar. A diviner of the Divination Commission, after all.
Ugh! Sushong, snap out of it! A slacker Heliobus is getting into your head.
Qingjue, Qingjue. For you, life may have a seemingly infinite number of choices. That is because your choices are simply different ways of slacking off and wasting time. They are of no consequence to anything. But for me, choices come with very real consequences.
That's the most divinery thing you've said so far.
As the master diviner of the Lafu, I have a heavy responsibility. I must comb through the complex threads of destiny day after day, all for the preservation of this giant ship. Some paths look promising, but lead to an abyss of despair. Then there are small trails that plunge deep into unimaginable darkness. And in the end, I realize that we have no real choices. There is only one path to follow, only one way to the optimal solution, even if it is paved with ashes and bitterness. There is only one way, and there only ever was.
What do we do? I don't think we can persuade her.
I have a proposal. Why don't we try a more advanced sandbox?
However long you want to play this game, and whatever tricks you try to pull, I'll happily play along.
Miss Qingjue!
Use your free will to guide the Ingenium out of the sandbox. Let's begin. Lead the Ingenium to the exit. Show me how many choices destiny gives you.
No match for me.
The path changed slightly, but it was just as simple. I'm sure the Master Diviner would say.
Destiny only has one path. Your choices are just a predetermined solution to the puzzle.
Actually, I don't think I agree. Master Diviner, let's reset the sandbox and give it another go, shall we?
Again? Do it all over again, exactly as it was. You can try it a million times over, and a million times over it is doomed to the same fate, because there is only one path. I see what you're thinking, Qingjue. You're an interesting one.
Qingjue, I've been thinking through the calculations for this puzzle. There really is only one solution.
case was designed by Caroloom. It's no use. There aren't any other solutions. As long as we're playing this so-called game of destiny, we can't win.
No, there's a second choice. There will always be another choice.
Mr. Trailblazer, quick, say something to persuade her.
Ready to begin? Of course there's another solution to this sandbox. Listen to my idea. You're all gonna help, right?
Miss Qingchue, I don't know how you're planning to solve the puzzle, but I'll support this squad to the end.
Count me in. I'm sure Miss Qingchue has something up her sleeve.
If we can help, I'm in.
I only need two people for my plan to work.
Destiny only has one path. Your choices are just a predetermined solution to the puzzle. Destiny only has one path.
You go stand in the sandbox. Right about that spot over there. Next, Judge Huohuo, you stand on the other side of the room. And stop shaking. All right, we're ready. And now, the second path appears.
Let's begin. Lead the Ingenium to the exit. Show me how many choices Destiny gives you.
So that's a...
This is the other solution. The alternative choice. I created a new solution. Master Diviner, you're not the only one who can design a puzzle. And I don't tread the path of destiny alone.
You think that by calling on your companions for help, you created a new path out of thin air? You're just playing with semantics. I could weave a thousand routes for you, but they lead to the same destination. So what significance is there in having a choice?
Creatures like you don't understand humans. The universe is like jade tiles on a game table. When the tiles are shuffled, the outcome is already predetermined. Which tiles can be played, which tiles are left over, what kind of hand the person next to you is trying to make. All of these can be determined through calculations. But if everything is just a calculation, the game loses its flavor. Randomness and adaptability, ambushing your opponent. Twists and turns, the balance of the elements. It's a mix of calculations, unknowns, and loss of complete control that makes Celestial Jade the kind of game it is. And those are the same things that give life its color and vibrance. Do my choices at the game table mean nothing if I have a sure loss in front of me? No! The choices are what make the game meaningful in the first place. Even if I lose, I'll still make choices to lighten the loss. Just like the Master Diviner is making choices for her own agenda. You were right when you said that as Master Diviner, you must comb through the complex threads of destiny day after day, all for the preservation of this giant ship. In this vast universe, a game where there are only losers, our Master Diviner is making endless choices, fighting against the odds just so the Lawful can travel safely for another day. In my book, she's the best player there is. Why would someone as talented as the Master Diviner go through the trouble of making endless choices if the end result is predetermined? Heliobus, you cannot fathom the joys of humanity. You are imprisoned by the illusion of destiny, unable to free yourself. And you want everyone who peeks into the future to suffer the same pain as you. You don't understand humans at all.
Don't let them trick you, Fu Xuan! Don't push me away! Don't let her words fool you!
Kiriloom, release the Master Diviner!
I see through your trickery! I see through every bit of it! I'm going to lose! Victory is beyond my reach! Why? Why is there no alternative? Everything in this universe is predetermined. No! I had no path to victory.
Come on, I'm gonna try something out.
Guard.
I'll free you from your chains. Disappear among the sea of butterflies. Illusions of the past.
Let me tend your wounds.
Misery.
visions of the past!
Need a doctor?
Lance at the ready. Lance ablaze. Lance!
Forward!
Guard.
The most powerful fragment, but becoming entangled in their illusion can lead to endless despair.
Hurry! Just hurry up and see me in the darkness. I've foreseen what happens next. You're going to imprison me.
Jingjue, thanks to you, the Divination Commission is safe again.
No need to thank me, Master Diviner. By the way, while you were possessed, you fired me from the Commission. So, that counts, right? I'll have to ask you to give me written notice that my contract's been unilaterally terminated. Then, with all the years I've spent in the Divination Commission, I'll be able to get a great severance package! And I already planned what to do with all the money. I'm gonna open a gaming parlor, hire a couple of workers to run it, and spend the rest of my days living off the profits. I'll have started a new life without having lifted a finger.
Are there two Jingjues?
I see. What a pity. I don't recall anything I may or may not have said while possessed by the Heliobus.
In any case, Qingchue, why are you still here? Shouldn't you be on duty back at the repository?
Huh? Master Diviner, you can't back out now!
Of course I can. After all, there are always choices in life. You taught me that. I can't convince real you, let alone possessed you. Master Diviner, you should get some rest. I'm gonna go take a get back to work. My actions today brought great shame on the Divination Commission. I shall have to think of a way to keep her from talking. Just kidding.
Heliobi are good at finding people's weaknesses and exploiting them. Everyone has some kind of weakness. You're not to blame.
That's right. You were just a victim of the Heliobus's trickery, Diviner Fu. No need to blame yourself.
I must express my sincere gratitude to all of you for your help. Apologies, but the Divination Commission is in disarray at the moment. I must return and set things in order. I'm afraid I cannot see you off in person.
Wait! There's something we need to ask you.
What is it? I agree that the Master Diviner gets possessed wouldn't make for a good headline. I don't care how you spin the story, so long as you leave my name and identity out of it.
Thank you.
I have many things to attend to. Please allow me to save my thanks for another day.
We won't delay you any longer. We need to go to Fixtral Garden and seal Garolum away.
Seems that your operations have met with some success. I've been browsing through some of the stories on Ghostly Grove myself. They make for good reading. Enjoy listening to storytellers and watching immersion. In both cases, tales have a predetermined ending. But you shouldn't let that stop you from enjoying them, should you? The same is true of life. Whether the end is predestined or not, it's worth living. As the saying goes, serious divination concerns serious matters. It is inevitable that someone performing divination day in and day out for the Cienjo would acquire inner demons, and Heliobus can take advantage of those. Fortunately, with your help, Fu Shren prevailed over her intruder. Very well, then. Miss Hanya is waiting for you by the suppression towers.
Of the Ten Lords Commission, I commend you for your great service in resolving the Divination Commission crisis. I will honor all of you before the Ten Lords.
Thanks, Madam Hanya. But, we really couldn't have defeated Carolyn without Miss Chingtrae's help.
I didn't realize that one as skilled as Diviner Fu would also be susceptible to the power of the Heliobai. That said, I can understand her plight. After all, we're all moving forward on our own unseen paths in no uncertain terms. Judges are instructed by the Ten Lords to carry out their orders, but no one ever explains their meaning to us. Just like the Master Diviner, no matter what cruel and horrible paths she foresaw, as long as it benefited the Lofu, she had to make a choice. Those choices may be correct and far-sighted, but we are, after all, flesh and blood, and we cannot help but agonize over the process of making them.
Madam Hanya?
I apologize. I was getting carried away. I think all the paperwork must have worn down my mental acuity. Today's business is finished. Please get some good rest.
Right. Let's call it a day. And you too, Judge Hanya. Don't work yourself to death.
It's finally time to get back to bed. Goodbye, everyone.
Apologies for rambling on just now.
Nice.
Today's work is finished. Please make sure to get some rest.
Chains! Disappear among the sea of butterflies! Illusions of the past!
cleansing dragon.
Lance ablaze.
Lance! Forward!
Times are changed. Seven search. Break!
Let me tend your wounds! Time to question your prescription!
Changed. Seven search. Break.
Time to show you what's in your prescription.
I'm on guard.
Don't mess with me.
Good.
I'll end your misery. Come on, I want to try something out. Illusions of the past!
They're ready. The Times are changed. Heaven Surge. Break!
You don't look so good.
Ready.
So you aren't afraid of me.